Welcome to ragurkul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to create Chessboard, which is a gaming application we are using on different players we can play it. So Chessboard is nothing but a game portal where 8x8 total 64 blocks are there. By using this block, we are playing. So pawns are there, then there are different main players or main role player is there, like queens, king. So by using this, we are playing the chessboard, which is a gaming application. So while creating gaming applications, how we can code, we'll show you from scratch. So by using Matplotlib library and Python numpy, I will show you how to create chessboard in Python. So let's begin with this. First, we have to import Matplotlib library. For importing Matplotlib library, we have to write import, then space Matplotlib is the library name dot plot as plt. Then second, we have to import numpy. Import numpy as np. Then from matplotlib library, we have to call something like colors so that we can give color to our chessboard. Matplotlib dot colors. And here we have to import log norm. So this will give us a beautiful color design pattern where we can use it for our chessboard. You can see this type of chessboard. We are going to design it here. So once we'll run this code, we'll get this type of chessboard. So let's create the actual logic about this code. So I am taking here as a dp comma dy. These are the variable we are going to use inside the program. So I am giving here as a dp value 0.015 and dy value is 0.05. Okay, post that. Let's assign some variables. In p, I am going to declare np dot arrange. Inside this, we are going to provide the index value, which is in -4.0, 4.0, dp. Which we have declared on top. Post that, I am going to declare y equal to np, which is a num py acronym which we have provided here. So np dot arrange is the command, and inside the same we are going to copy like above, but here we are going to declare as dy. dy. Now, next things we are going to call in uppercase p comma y and equal to np dot mesh grid. So this will create a complete mesh for us, like this mesh np dot mesh grid. Here we are going to call same variable which we have created earlier, that is py. Now next thing, we are going to provide minimum and maximum range for this. So let's call here add extent equal to np dot min. Inside this we are going to call p here and post that np dot max. So minimum maximum value of both we are going to declare it here. Now next things, we are going to build the same logic for y as well. So let me copy and paste it here. Just change the variable name. So post changing that, we will get the actual response. So here y, and again in this I'm going to paste it y here. Now when we call as the index, so in the outer range what we going to provide here, so in the outer range let me add here z11 equal to np dot add dot outer. Inside this we are going to provide the value as range 8 comma range 8 modulus operator 2. Then in the plot image show, we will give you here plt dot im show. Then we are going to call same z11 and cmap equal to in double quote binary underscore r then interpolations is nearest outside the double quote interpolation equal to nearest extent equal to extent, and then alpha value is 1, alpha equal to 1. Now here we are done, just have to check the complete this, and we are going to close this bracket, and this one we will paste it into next line. Now this is done. Let's define the actual play, actual functions where we will call the chess variable. So here define chess. This is my function. Here I will call p comma y and return the value. So for returning the value, we are going to use return. Inside the return function, we will call 1 minus p divide by p divide by 2 plus p into 5 plus y into 6. Now close the press. Next thing, we are going to multiply with np variable. So np dot exp here I am giving minus, and inside this bracket we are going to provide p into 2 plus y into 2. Now this function is ready. Let me create second variable where we will give the name as Z22 equal to chess. Chess and the same variable we will call like above we have declared. Now this is done. Let's show image, that is plot dot imshow. Here we are going to use the same variable which we have created on top. So this is Z22 and then alpha value. We are going to declare here as a alpha equal to 0.2. Now interpolation we are going to declare has a bilinear and extent. So interpolation equal to bilinear near comma extent equal to extent. Now we are done. Let's provide the name of the chessboard. So here I am giving plt.title. Title, I am calling this as a chessboard space. Now our title is done. Let's print this. So it's plt.show. Now we are done. Let's check it. Here we have imported matplotlib.pyplot as plt, then imported numpy as numpy. From matplotlib we have called matplotlib.colors import log norm. Here we have declared two variables where we have provided the value in decimals, then x place we are calling as p, y place we are calling as y, np.arrange, and then the same value. Then we have created a new variable where we are calling this variable in terms of np.meshgrid, where we have used these two variables. In extent field, we are calling minimum maximum of both the variable. And next tab, we have used np.addRouter, which is the range divided on modulus 2. Plot imshow, I am giving as z11 cmap binary underscore r interpolation nearest and extent alpha we are giving here 1. In the second tab, we have given alpha 4.2. So let's run this and see the result. Now, in definitions, we have not provided the colon. That's why it's showing error. Now, you can see PNP dot here. We have made a mistake of ARANGE. Instead of arrange, we have provided double R. Now, let's run again. NG22 chess XY up. We have not defined X here, we have defined P. So this will generate my graph bilinear n by, it's not double L, it's linear. Now I can see my complete chessboard is generated. So in at the typing, we have made a mistake, like calling instead of calling arrange, we have inserted here ERRANG, and bilinear, we have provided the double L. So if we make the changes and we will use this type of structure, definitely you will get chessboard is created, which is very interesting. You can increase the alpha value where you can get a different additional colors in between the chessboard. So you will feel this. You can see this is how it becomes. You can change it to 1.2. And run it. It's not this one. Alpha 1, you can keep it and change this one. 0.9. This will become more and more darker, and you can see this is a very interesting chessboard is generated. So this is how we can create a chessboard by using Python Matplotlib library and NumPy. Hope you liked it. If you really enjoyed and you feel this is very much interesting, which will help the other as well, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.